The first Noel, the angel did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, Noel,
well, Merry Christmas, everyone. Let's all stand together. Lord, we love you. We praise you. We are excited to worship you, to celebrate the fact that you were born to us in a manger. Lord, thank you, Jesus, that you came for us so that we could live forever with you. We rejoice in you today. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, amen. Come on, let's worship the Lord together.
To the world, the Lord is come. Let
Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
Thank you.
give him the glory. We worship you, Jesus, the strong Son of God. Jesus, you came to this earth over 2,000 years ago, born in a manger, took upon yourself humanity, lived a sinless life for 33 years, died on a cross, rose again on the third day so that we could have life forevermore. Jesus, you took what we deserved. You took the death that we deserved and gave us eternal life. And this Christmas, Lord, we celebrate you, Jesus. We celebrate the fact that we've received the greatest gift of all, and that is you, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. We love you. We praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want us to read this together. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. The census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord." Amen. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, and let's say this together, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." Lord, we love you, we praise you, we thank you that this is a joyous day because you were born to us so that we could be forever with you. We love you in Jesus' name, and all of God's children say, amen. Amen. Well, we have a great, great service ahead. We have Jenna Raine with us today. We have CAIN, Dave Barnes, Michelle Williams, and our very own Rebecca Hart singing "O Holy Night." But before that, why don't you turn around, greet one another, let someone know you're glad to see them. Merry Christmas.
Welcome to our Candlelight services. We're so glad you're here.
At Gateway, we're all about people because God is all about people. We have so many ways for you to get connected to ministry and each other. Here are some great places to start.
To stay up to date with all that's going on, visit gatewaypeople.com.
If you'd like to join us in what God is doing in and through Gateway, you can give on our website, our mobile app, or in any of the offering boxes at any of our campuses.
There's so many ways you can discover community at Gateway. You can join a group, attend an equip class, or serve on our build team. To learn more, meet us at Connect Central. Text CONNECT to 71010 or visit gatewaypeople.com.
To stay connected with the Gateway family throughout the week, follow us on social media and join our campus Facebook group.
We're so glad you joined us. Thanks for being here today.
This is my favorite week of the year at Gateway Church because this is our conference. This is for us as a church to come together to be in the presence of God, to hear these anointed men and women of God speak. I can't explain to you how important it is that we gather just once a year and give the first of our year to God. Hey everyone, as you can see, we are coming up on our first conference, and really it's when we give the first of our year to the Lord. And I have been so praying about this and so burdened about us as a congregation giving the first of our lives to Jesus Christ every year like this. And so I was reminded of an article that I found years ago. So I actually want to read you that article. I think you'll find this interesting. A young boy by the name of James had a desire to be the most famous manufacturer and salesman of cheese in the world. He planned on becoming rich and famous by making and selling cheese, and he began with a little buggy pulled by a pony named Patty. After making his cheese, he would load his wagon and he and Patty would drive down the streets of Chicago to sell the cheese. As the months passed, the young boy began to despair because he was not making any money in spite of his long hours and hard work. So one day he pulled his pony to a stop and he began to talk to him. He said, "Patty, there's something wrong. We're not doing it right. I'm afraid we have things turned around and our priorities are not where they ought to be. Maybe we ought to serve God and place Him first in our lives." The boy drove home and made a covenant that for the rest of his life, he would serve God first and then work as God directed. Many years after this, the young boy, now a man, stood as Sunday school superintendent at North Shore Baptist Church in Chicago. And he said, "I would rather be a layman in the North Shore Baptist Church than to head the greatest corporation in America. My first job is serving Jesus." So, every time you take a bite of Philadelphia cream cheese, sip a cup of Maxwell House, mix a quart of Kool-Aid, slice up a DiGiorno pizza, cook a pot of macaroni and cheese, spread some gray poupon, stir a bowl of cream of wheat, slurp down some Jell-O, eat the cream out of the middle of an Oreo cookie, or serve some stovetop, remember a boy, his pony named Patty, and the promise that James L. Craft made to serve God first and work as he directed. That's what I want us to do. I want to ask you to join us in our fast. We'll begin this year, January the 14th, that weekend. I'll be back in the pulpit beginning a new series, and we'll fast and pray for 21 days. And I want you just to fast however the Lord leads you. And I mean, even if the Lord leads you to start on January the 1st, like I do, I like to start on the first day of the year. Doesn't matter about that. Just 21 days of prayer and fasting and seeking God. But I really have a burden and a desire that every person at Gateway Church be able to attend the first conference, whether in person or online, but attend the first conference. God called Israel to come together three times a year. He knew there was something that happened when we come together. He knows that, and so He calls us to that. So as your pastor, I'm asking you to put God first, serve God first, and make sure, if you can, attend the first conference. Hey, I love you so much, and Merry Christmas.
I'm so excited to be here at Gateway this Christmas. Would you stand up on your feet with me? How are y'all doing? Everybody good? Y'all can sit down. I know that I could feel the pressure, but it's like, bring it. This is not a bring it song. I have to tell you this, first of all, this Christmas is one of my favorite songs. I have a few Christmas records myself, and I've recorded it. It doesn't sound near that good, but it's my version of it. But this week, true story, this week, that song came on the radio, and my kids know my version of it. So my son says, "Dad, listen to how well they're singing your song." And I was like, "Oh, I didn't." He's like, "You wrote that, right?" I was like, "I wanted to lie because that would look really cool, but I didn't." And this is a church, so I'm not going to lie tonight either. I had to break the news to him. I thought, "Son, if I had written that song, we'd be living in a yacht copter above the this Mediterranean somewhere." This also, sadly, is not a song. I did not write this song, but I love this song, and I love singing it. But this is a song called "It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year."
It's the most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all, with those kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the happiest season of all. And marshmallows for toasting and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales, the glories of Christmases long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoe and hearts will be glowing when young ones are near. It's the most wonderful is for hosting, marshmallows for roasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales, the glories of Christmas is long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoe and hearts will be glowing when loved ones.
Thank you. So, I have to admit, I looked up there and I saw that's me. And I remembered the first service that I had to remember to suck my gut in because I wasn't wearing a guitar. And no, I did. I was like, strengthened core, not ignore the core. That was my workout regimen for years, sadly. But engage the core, because true story, I was shooting a music video years ago on this beach in Malibu, in LA, and my wife was on the shoot, and so they're doing the thing, and there's no audio, you know, you're just kind of fake singing along, and I had like a t-shirt on and pants too, but just people feel like I need to clarify that, and so I was walking, and the director yells cut, and he's kind of like, hey Dave, and I walk over, and he's like, hey, so your wife wanted to tell you something. And I was like, okay. And she's like, you got to suck in. You just need to suck in. And I was like, and she said, the shirt, the wind is blowing and it's just not a good look. So you need to remember to suck in. And isn't it weird? That's why I love her. Isn't that why we love our spouses? Because they tell us hard things. And so I have mild trauma whenever I don't have my guitar now. Just sort of relive that moment over and over until you saw it real time. So sorry if that was something you had experienced. This next song is one of my favorite Christmas songs, and I love singing it, so you might know it.
Tell it all. Silent flocks by night. No
keep it going for Mr. Dave Barnes one time. Hi, everyone.
Hi. Merry Christmas. I wanted to introduce us. We are the CAIN family. Yay, hi. Some of you may have come here tonight thinking, well, tonight, this morning, and we're wondering why a Christian band would call themselves CAIN.
Yes.
And it's because we are murderers.
Stop.
No. We did not name our band after a murder. We're the CAIN family. It's our last name. And I'm excited. We're going to play you one of our favorite Christmas songs. It's some that we would sing constantly growing up. And I'm not going to age myself, but when we would listen to this song, it was on cassette tape. Yes. So much that it broke. And so you can tell your kids that that's not something they can download on an app.
Right.
It goes in a thing. But I've been feeling it a lot this Christmas because the older you get, you just try to recreate the magic. Whenever I was little, I would hear this song and be like, I can't wait to be grown up and have my grown-up Christmas list. And now that I'm older, I just want to be a kid again.
So we don't know what's on your Christmas list this year, but here's ours. Childhood fantasies.
Well, I'm all grown up now, and I still need help somehow. No, I'm not a child, but my heart still can dream.
So here's my lifelong wish, my grown-up Christmas list. Not for myself, but for a world in need. Sing it with me. No more lives torn apart. The wars would never start, and time would heal all hearts. Everyone would have a friend, and right would all.
Children, we believe
Y'all. Hello, hello. I am Jenna Raine, and I am so excited to be back here. Gateway is actually my home church, so woo-woo! Really happy to be back. I just have so many sweet and fond memories here, and I grew up going to students, and this is the church that I fell in love with Jesus. So really sweet to be back, and I have been to every single Candlelight service since I was born. So it's just, I guess, a really sweet thing to be here, a sweet, sweet blessing. So very honored to be here, and I love my Gateway family, and I am praying y'all have yourselves a merry little Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough. A merry little Christmas now. Ooh, Christmas now.
Thank you.
This, I felt so cool the music was starting and the lights, I was here. This next song, I have three kids, and one of the things that I'm the most fascinated with the Christmas story is Mary and Joseph, and just kind of how I think I take for granted the plight of parents in this season with Jesus, and not just raising him, but just having him and what that would have been like. I can't imagine, but I think as a parent, I think about this a lot when I read the story, and it makes it come to life in a very different way. And so I wanted to write a song just sort of about that from their perspective, thinking what it might have been like for me if that would have been, you know, my life. But I didn't have three Jesuses. I had kids that are very not Jesus. and yes, I'm sucking in. I know y'all are judging me right now. But this is... This is a song I had a lot of fun writing, thinking about that. It's a song called Angel Boy.
Sleeping, counting every breath.
was climbing up those old trees. You scared us half to death. And I've still got your blanket and your basket full of toys. You'll always be mine. Is a promise, but the angel said came true. But he made sure that he left out what you'd have to do. It's the biggest kind of blessing to do the Father's will. The vow you had to keep, but the man who hung there dying was the boy I sang to sleep. Someday I'll sing your praises with a heart so full of joy, but you'll always be my angel boy.
Gateway, I had a very cool jacket on in the first service, and I took it off so I could be more expressive in worship tonight with you. Of all the things the prophet Isaiah said he would be, the first thing they said he would be is wonderful. And I don't know where you're at tonight, but we have a God who's not just for us. He's with us, and he's here tonight. Are you thankful for a wonderful counselor in this house tonight?
Yes.
Gathered round the table, so much to be thankful for. It's Christmas. Oh, how I missed it. Through the joy and laughter, you can feel the sadness. 'Cause this Christmas, everyone's not with us.
It's the time of year when happiness and cheer won't be enough to get me through the night. I need a wonderful counselor, the mighty God, the Prince of Peace, who's strong enough to carry me. Emmanuel, God with us, the one whose love will never end. Oh, Jesus, can you make this season wonderful?
If you feel it, would you stand and worship the wonderful counselor with me in this place tonight? Come on, let's worship the King.
Yeah. Almighty in the manger, told us he'd be no stranger to all our sorrow and all the hurt we'll ever know. So let these gifts remind us how love came down to find us. The wonder of the ages, the light, the truth, the way. He is our wonderful,
wonderful
counselor.
still he appeared, and the soul felt its worth.
Thank you for the life that you've given us. Jesus, you were born on this day in a manger, but we celebrate that you are the eternal King who lives forever and ever and ever. Lord, we declare that you are holy and you're worthy of all of our praise. We love you and we praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I just want to say thank you for coming to our service. We have I want to invite our prayer team to come down. We have prayer team pastors down here who would love to pray with you if you have any prayer needs. I want to remind you that we have our first conference coming up in two weekends, January 6th through 10th. Come out, as Pastor Robert said, come out and be a part of that. as well as we have a devotional called No Love Like This. You can pick up a copy in the bookstore, but they are for free on gatewaydevotions.com, or you also can go to the YouVersion app for the devotional. It's both in English and in Spanish. Looking forward to seeing you. Lord, we love you. We praise you. We thank you for this season. We celebrate you, Jesus, in Jesus' name. Amen. Merry Christmas to you. God bless you. Have a wonderful Christmas.